Hello friends, welcome to my channel. This is going to be the first video in the drilling machine series, and this video is particularly about the buying guide. I'll give you best and quick tips to buy the suitable drilling machine for your use case, okay? And I'll also tell you whether you should have a drilling machine or not. I'll tell you the pros and cons, okay? And in the subsequent series, subsequent videos in the series, I'm going to show you how to use a drilling machine for various use cases. For example, for drilling the concrete, for drilling the tiles, for drilling the wood. I'll make all those videos, okay? But this video is particularly going to be about the buying guide. So let's start with the tips, okay? So the first tip is the size. So when you buy the drilling machine, they come in the size like 10 mm, 20, 13 mm, 15 mm, 20 mm, okay? So this one is 13 mm. And 13 mm is good enough for the domestic use cases. I have been using this drilling machine for more than 4 years, roughly about 5 years, and I have done roughly about 300 to 400 drills with this drilling machine, okay? Perhaps more, but not less, okay? And I have never faced a need of a bigger drilling bit. For example, I'll show you this bit, okay? So this is 12 mm. Now I'm talking about the thickness, okay, not the length. Length is not important. Even for a thinner one, you can have a bigger length. So length is not important. So for example, let me just show you this one. This is 12 mm. I'm not sure if you're able to see in the video or not, but this is 12 mm bit. So with this, you can assume that 13 mm would be obviously more than sufficient for all the domestic use cases, okay? And if you want to go for the commercial use case, then you can go for the 20 mm, okay? But don't go for the 10 mm, because you will in some certain use cases will not be, you know, fulfilled with the 10 mm. So go for the 13 mm. That's what I recommend. If you get a 15 mm, then you can keep it, that go for that one also as a buffer case. But trust me, that won't be required for the domestic use case. 13 mm is sufficient. Now this is the first tip. Now second one is the RPM. You need to see that what is the biggest RPM, it's maximum RPM it supports, okay? For example, mine supports 2600 RPM, okay? So usually drill machines, the good drill, but machines come in the speeds. So speeds are multiple speeds, like 0, 1, 2, okay? So when you run it at the second speed, the maximum speed, what is the RPM, okay? So the faster it rotates, better it can drill, okay? So the RPM should be above 2000 and somewhere close to 2500, okay? That will be sufficient. For example, this is having 2600 RPM, and this is sufficient for almost all use cases. And the third thing is the power. This has 400 watt power, and this power is important to, you know, generate the torque. For example, when your drilling machine is stuck, then is it able to move itself or not? If it is having less power, then it won't be able to move itself. So you should be having somewhere close to 400 or above, somewhere close to, if you can get even better, then it is better, okay? For example, I have explored the Amazon, and I have selected a best product covering all the, you know, the tips which I'm suggesting in the video. And you can explore that. I'll put the link of that product in the description. So that is from the Black & Decker, and that supports 550 watts, okay? And that generates 4.5 newton meter of torque, okay? So you can go for the higher torque, higher the better, simple formula, okay? Don't compromise on torque, and there is no upper limit. But so this is having somewhere close to 3.5 mm, newton meter of torque, and the 4.5 will be obviously more than sufficient for all the use cases. Now that is the third tip, the power. And the fourth tip is like, are you getting the accessories or not? For example, the free drill bits and the handle like this, okay? And the measuring scale like this. So these things I will cover in the next video, how to use these tools, okay? But what exactly this is? This is a handle. With a single handle, sometimes it's a little difficult to, you know, manage the drill machine when you're drilling multiple times, multiple holes, okay? And this scale is a measuring scale. This will help you in, you know, deciding the hole size, the depth of the hole, okay? So whether you're getting the right accessories or not. So now these are the actually important tips. One last tip is like the cord length, okay? How much length of the cord you're getting, because if you're getting very short, then you would require extension for every little thing also. So it should be somewhere close to two meters or 3 meters, but this is not an important criteria. Don't, you know, decide based on this thing, because you can use extension always, okay? So that's it about this drilling machine. And also one important thing is like, it should be reversible. Reversible means it should run in both directions. For example, and when you do the clockwise is for drilling inside, okay? But what happens is when you're done with the drilling, your drill bit will get stuck inside. So you need to take it out. So for taking out, you need to change the direction, okay? There is always a knob like this, or, you know, it can be a different position, but it should be reversible. when you do this, then it will run the reverse direction and you can easily take the drill bit out. Okay, so having a reversible is very important. Also, you know, drilling bits is now I'll tell you whether you should have the drilling machine or not. So drilling machine is the most important tool in the you know, the toolkit. If you want to do the repair work and the installation work at your home on your own, then you can simply go for the drilling machine. You should have a drilling machine because, for example, I have been using this drilling machine for about 5 years, and trust me, I have saved a lot of time and money also. I can say roughly about 50,000 I have saved, you know, because those many drills I have done with this drilling machine. So having this drilling machine is very economic product, and it lasts for many, many years. For 5 years, it didn't give me any problem. Okay, and these bits, even if you don't get free bits, then this costs about 30 to 40 rupees. You can buy it from the local shop, or you can buy a bundle from the online. Okay, which collection of all the drill bits. So now this is useful to drill the wood also. When you want to install something on the wood, this is useful to drill the tiles also. You can drill the tiles also if you want to install something in the bathroom or in the kitchen. Okay, and you can drill the concrete. Okay, and you can also use some tools like this for cutting. If you want to cut a wood in a proper shape, okay, then these kind of tools are available in the online. Okay, and you can also, you know, use as a screwdriver. For example, you see this is also a bit, but this is a screwdriver kind of bit. Okay, so you can put it at the zero speed, okay, which will run this machine at somewhere close to 800 RPM, okay, and install this bit and then use it as a screwdriver. So you don't have to do it manually. Let's say you want to install something which requires screwing a lot of things, and then you can use this one. It will save your labor. Okay, so the use case of drilling machines are too many, and this is the most essential toolkit, and I can't survive without this thing. Okay, and this is the most important thing in my toolkit. So I recommend, if you want to try out, you know, installing and repairing things at your home, then you should have a drilling machine. It will save your time and the money also. Time means if you call a labor, then they will come on their own time, and you will end up wasting more time than doing things on your own. So having drilling machine, I strongly recommend. And in the subsequent video, I'll show you how to use it and also the safety precautions. So once you follow them, it is harmless and it's safe also. Okay, so that's it, guys. That's it for this video. Thank you very much. Thank you for watching. If you like this content, please hit the like button and subscribe my channel for more videos. Thank you.